Right, let's talk about skate four. I really don't know where to start, so I'm just gonna kind of hit every point that I can, and hopefully it all makes sense when I'm done. I've been waiting a long time to talk about this game. I mean a long time, like everyone else. It's been too long, over 10 years, long enough. Personally, I'm a big Tony Hawk fan, and it was a real heartbreaker to watch Tony Hawk kind of just go down the tubes. I didn't even play Pro Skater 5, and I'm really happy with the remakes, but ever since Skate came out, it's been a completely different experience playing a skateboarding video game. I used to love Tony Hawk because I used to be able to do the most ridiculous combos that I could possibly imagine. Skate really challenged you to think like a skateboarder, not like a gamer. And I think that's what most skaters like about it. I think that's what a lot of gamers find challenging about it, because if they don't skateboard, then you really got your work cut out for you. But anyways, this video is really just for me to start the conversation about EA Skate, Skate 4, whatever it's going to be, because it's important to me, and I want to be a part of it, and I want other people to enjoy it with me, because I've always been a kind of a lone wolf gamer. That's probably my fault, which is okay. Like, I don't have any qualms about it, but as I've gotten older, it would be nice to have people to play with, and I really figured out what games I like to play the most. Call of Duty and Halo and all the first-person shooters and the Battle Royales and the Fortnites and the PUBGs and blah, 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 blah. It's all just kind of washed over me, and I've still always loved my Tony Hawk games, loved skate games, and I want to see that trend continue. I want to see people inspired not only to skateboard by skateboarding video games, but also inspired to persevere. Anyways, I really want to make predictions about Skate now, because I think that a lot of people are wondering what it's going to be like, and we got to see one video, and that video left a lot to the imagination, which I think was the point, and I think that they did a really great job in executing that, but that doesn't leave me very satisfied. I don't know about you. The first thing I want to address is the possibility that it's going to be free to play. I think that's a really strong possibility, mainly because that's where the entire industry is starting to move into this free-to-play world. I think Skate is very viable for a free-to-play game because it's inviting and it's accessible. The main draw will be cosmetic items. It will be style. Fashion is only second to what you land and what you can do in the skateboarding world. And if anybody disagrees with that, I'm sorry. Tell me I'm wrong, but I'm not. There's more money in skateboarding fashion than there is in skateboarding magazines and movies. And if you don't believe that, then you're in denial. You're in denial. Anyways, the free-to-play model fits Skate really, really well. And I think that it would probably be the best way to go in order for it to market itself most effectively. If Skate could essentially achieve some sort of Fortnite-like reputation for being an accessible place for people to hang out, have a fashion show, or do their competitions, and obviously there's going to be tricks, that's very enticing. I mean, if I had had that when I was 13, if there had been that kind of metaverse, this online world for me to go and skateboard in with all my friends, and I'm not talking about PlayStation 2 online, that was whack. And even Skate 3, I know I have a lot of admiration for the guys that can do the competitive thing, but also kind of whack. Not what they do, but the way that the whole competitive online mode was set up for Skate 3. It wasn't really built for longevity in mind. It was just kind of meant to be cool and just be slightly more cool than couch co-op. You know, it was a gimmick back then. It wasn't a necessity. Now, imagine a 64-person free skate. And everybody's in there and everybody gets to pick out all their different cosmetic options, complete tricks in order to pass milestones, in order to get better gear, or you sign on with a brand and, you know, you earn specifically from that brand. I don't know. I'm not here to try and drum up ways to create microtransactions for the game, because the truth is, if it was full price, I would pay for it and I wouldn't complain at all, especially if there weren't microtransactions. I think it would be better if there were no microtransactions and people paid for the game, for the sake of gaming. For the sake of the success of the game, I think it's more viable for them to go with the free-to-play option, and that's probably what they'll do, and we'll just have to live with it. Second prediction. Flatland. Now I get to talk about something I enjoy. I love Flatland. Who's with me? Right? Rodney Mullen, watching his old tapes back in the day. That's inspiration in a bottle right there. And that's what got me interested in skateboarding, period. I wouldn't even have bought a Tony Hawk game, or if anyone remembers back on the Dreamcast days, Andy McDonald's Pro Skateboarding. I wouldn't have bought those games if it weren't for the Primo flips and the Casper slides and the 360s and the 720s on flat ground. That was the stuff that made people want to get on a skateboard. That was the street surfing that inspired me and that I really enjoy the most. All the crazy big vert Danny Way stuff. I mean, it's awesome, but it's not for me. So Flatland is definitely, I think, going to be one of the most desired things that should be coming out of this game. It was really, really disappointing to kind of get teased in Skate 3 with Flatland, because you were able to do the dark catches and you were able to do the dark slides, but no Casper slide? I mean, it seemed like it was supposed to fit. I mean, it didn't seem like it was going to be that much more of an ask. I'm not a developer, so I don't know the ins and outs of how much harder it would be to make a manual happen with the board upside down. But what I do know is that Tony Hawk's Project 8 was able to accomplish that, and their Nail the Trick system was inspired by skate controls. And the system itself kind of sucked, because you were just basically doing like the most insane Matrix style flips, but you can land in manuals and you could get a Casper slide out, if I remember correctly. It's either here nor there. That's pretty much the only thing that's missing from a realistic approach to skateboarding from the original three games. I don't think that the Nada spin would be totally viable. I don't even really consider that a realistic trick. You know, I think that's kind of something that you can do on a board, but you can't really land in a line. I think Flatland is going to be the make it or break it for me, to be honest. I mean, if the Flatland's not in the game, then I'm going to be really disappointed and I'm going to have a lot of negative things to say, because if you weren't going to put that in the game, then what took so long getting another one out? I don't really want to accept a lot of excuses on this, and I'm sure a lot of people are with me where it's like, we waited long enough. Like, if it's just going to be another kind of rehash of the game that you've already given us three times, why did we wait so long for it? Like, that's cool and it's awesome and we want to play it, but dude, like, I was a younger man when I really wanted this game, and now I'm finally trying to throw myself back into it, thinking like, wow, they actually care again. Flatland would easily be the most mind-blowing thing to be able to do in Skate, and I think that it would be really well appreciated from all the hardcore fans that have played it over the years, and I think it would be something to draw in a lot of newer, younger skaters that might be interested, because skateboarding's coming back, and I don't see any reason why Skate's not going to take full advantage of every trend that it possibly can in order to sell its game. Next prediction, we should be expecting a fully voiced protagonist. Just seems like kind of a given. I mean, whether you get to choose the options or, you know, it's just kind of a canned voice, like, it always feels kind of weird now when you have a silent protagonist. I don't like listening to all of my supporting characters speak for me, you know, especially when I think Skate 3 did it too, where they kind of step into the fourth wall a little bit and play off of the fact that your character doesn't speak, and that's really annoying. Like, you wrote it that way, you made it that way, you don't have to comment on it. Like, I was already kind of not happy about it. I don't know if we really need dialogue options for a skate game, but it was really enjoyable to hear my character speak in Tony Hawk's Underground when it came out. You know, those games having a voice protagonist really helped sell them along. Tony Hawk's American Wasteland really relied on those voiced protagonists. So I think that's kind of a given, and we should expect a good amount of male and female voices, hopefully with a wide amount of representation, because having even just three voices for a male and three voices for a female, that's not enough. So if they're gonna do it, I hope they do it right. And that kind of leads me to my next point, which is character customization. Everybody wants better character customization in any game. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how good it is. People will always want it to be better. But with Skate, it needs to be better. It needs to be a lot better, because everybody kind of feels like a weird little plastic doll. They're very lifeless. I think so much energy went into making sure that the board mechanics, with the way that the feet lined up and the legs and the kicks, which is important, so much went into that that we kind of forgot about them actually having any emotion in their face, and so they all just kind of look like husks. I do think that will change. Like I said, I think it'll go free to play. And with that free to play model, it's going to be an explosion of fashion. Look at Fortnite. Look at it. There's so much money to be made in fashion, in video games, more than there ever has been before. And there's a lot of money in skateboarding fashion. You do the rest. I am very uneasy when I think about how this game could be exploited and how young people could be exploited by this game, like they are by other games. I also don't care a whole lot because I'm not that young person anymore, and I've wanted a game like this for so long. So I hope that it's as big and as awesome as we all think it's going to be. Because if it's not, then I might just stop playing video games as a whole. This is, to me, one of the last chances for the video game industry to get something right for a player base that has remained patient and waited for so long without radicalizing. I mean, we're not Call of Duty players. We're not review bombing. We're not making death threats. We have nothing to do. It's been years and years and years. There's a lot of toxicity in the community, and I think sometimes it stems from the fact that we're friggin' bored. We are so bored. We're bored with each other. We're bored with the maps. We're bored with the same soundtrack, even. It's a great soundtrack, but oh my god, can anybody else just guess what might be on this next soundtrack for this game? Let me know in the comments, actually. What song do you want in Skate? Because there's more room than ever for a large, big, bombastic soundtrack, and EA has the money to cough up to really lay down some awesome licensed sound. So personally, I would love to see them kind of undercut a lot of the Tony Hawk albums, like get some Rage Against the Machine in there, get some Less Than Jake and Goldfinger, and get all of those same bands and all of those same artists. Bring in Del the Funky Homo Sapien and the Red Hot Chili Peppers and get a different song by them, and just show, like, we have the money, we have the funding, we can do it better, and keep that soundtrack rotating. If it's going to be a free-to-play game, and let people curate it so that it's something that people can interact with. I think it would be a lot of fun if people got a little bit more involved in how a game is determined. And since we're already releasing so many things in beta, we're already releasing so many things in this kind of early access state, I don't see any reason why Skate's going to be any different. So it will probably have an early access model, and it will probably have a beta, and we will probably have a chance to put a lot more feedback into a game like this than we ever had before, and that's really cool when it comes to a game that people really care about. I have some other predictions that are kind of just like little things. A lot of it's just kind of wishful thinking and stuff, just because, like, I've had a lot of time to think about it, and I've actually had to put off this video for a little bit. I've got two kids and a beautiful wife, and they need me more than you guys do. So I hope that it doesn't feel like too much of a rush for me to put this out, but I wanted to get my thoughts down, and I wanted to get everything out so that people just knew kind of where I stood about it, because I want to talk about this game. I don't care how or why or with who. So if you want to talk about this game, if you're interested in Skate, if you want to play Skate, you want to play Skate 3, leave your gamer tag in the comments, or find me on Twitter or TikTok at JacobStorm44, and just let me know. Like, I'm just trying to skate again, man, and I can't do it in real life anymore. I live in Rochester, New York. It's freezing cold outside. There's snow all over the ground, so there's no skating for me, whether I wanted to or not. I love skate video games. So I'm going to throw a few other little predictions at you, but then I'm probably going to get out of here because this has gone on for way too long, and I still got to edit the video. So, anyways, we're going to have a much better set of pros. I don't really care for the pros that they gave us in the skate games, and there's some that are definitely not going to make a reappearance. So I think the most interesting thing to look out for is the up-and-coming skaters, and it's going to become sort of this Madden style thing, like, are we going to put someone on the covers of Skate? You know, is it going to be that kind of thing? Are we going to turn this into kind of a FIFA type thing where every year we're going to re-release it with a new roster, new skaters, new music, new this, new that? I think that would be fun. I think it would get a little old. I don't think it would be viable long term, and I think it would get kind of set to the side after EA pursued other projects. But it's a possibility. I'm also predicting that there's going to be a much more improved open world. Skate 3 kind of reminds me of Tony Hawk's Proving Grounds. Proving Grounds? Skate 3 kind of reminds me of one of the Tony Hawk games that was kind of island-based. I think it was Proving Grounds. I don't remember anymore. It's not important. But the three island thing with different districts, and that's just been done to death. I mean, if anyone's played Crackdown, Grand Theft Auto 3, like I said, the Tony Hawk games, like there, in almost any iteration of any genre of game, there is a three island version. And I would really like to see a more flushed out, ready to live in open world that, I mean, needs to be seamless. It needs to be seamless, and I want it to have kind of that Grand Theft Auto 5 feel. Does it have to be the entire Grand Theft Auto 5 map in comparison size-wise? No. But like Los Santos, like if you gave me a Los Santos sized skate map, I think I'd be happy for an extremely long time. So I think the open world is going to be something that they're focused on. And once again, if it is free to play, it's going to be something that can evolve and could be a new map every year, every 6 months. Last but not least, let's talk photo mode and editors. Photo mode has gotten really, really popular since the PS3 days, you know, almost the entire last generation. Like, it was a premier thing to have a photo mode in your game, and a lot of games kind of suffered for not having one if they didn't. Even me, like, I got suckered into playing the Assassin's Creed Origins, playing with that photo mode for way longer than I should have. And like, I love Assassin's Creed, but I never once thought to myself, like, I'd really love to be able to take pictures in this game. No. So the photo mode's going to be really enticing. I just think that there's going to be a vast improvement on the editor, and it should expect to see a much more refined ability to kind of lay over things and make better transfers and longer edits, better camera angles, maybe even a better kind of automated editing system. So that way, you know, if you don't have the time to sit there and cut 30 different camera angles, like maybe there's just going to be a button that's like, oh, I want this to look more energized, whereas this one's kind of like a calm, like one shot, one take type thing. I think that there's going to be a much more AI assisted photo and editing mode. So that'd be cool. But yeah, those are my predictions and my thoughts on Skate coming out. So let me know what you thought about it down in the comments. And you know, I'd love to hear from you more, but if I don't, that's cool. I'll just be skating anyways. So thanks for listening.